Good morning, dear student, and welcome to the second part of the lecture on database management systems. I am Dr. Sachin R. Gengse, head and professor, Department of Electronics Engineer at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Learning outcome of this session include, at the end of this video lecture, after watching this, you will be able to explain need of database management system and can explain database management problems and challenges. We all already have seen the definition of data. The data is an elementary description of the thing, event, activities and transaction that are recorded, classified and stored, but not necessarily in an organized way. The database is nothing but if I store these data atoms in an organized way, then it becomes a database. For example, here I am showing how the class data, or rather the data related to a class, is being stored in a table. And then we can see that it is very easy to retrieve some data, or it is easy to retrieve certain information out of this database. And then that's why the data atoms which are stored in an organized way so that it can be easy for retrieval is called as the database. Now, database is basically an optimal way or organized way to deal with the data. Data, in case of database, the logical group of the related file is being stored. We can say that a database is a collection of data that is organized so that it can be easily accessed, managed and updated. So as a user need to access the database, or he need to manage the database, and he has to update the database. Database can also be thought of as a collection of schemas, table, queries, report, views and other objects. What is the advantage of using database, and of course along with that a database management system? We had look at this in the last lecture also, that one set of software program like the database management system provide access to all the data. Then the problems like the redundancy, isolation, inconsistency can be addressed. The same set of data can be shared among all applications or user. I think that this is a great advantage, that there is only one set of data in a database, and that it can be shared amongst different applications and different users. Then data security and data integrity can be increased. And another very important advantage is that the data and the application which are accessing the data are independent of each other. The database is being managed by a software called as the database management system. We are popularly called as DBMS. So this database management system are computer program used to manage the addition, updation and deletion of the data as the transaction occur. And they also support data queries and the reporting. So we know that there are two type of the query. One is called as an action query, other is called as the select query. So this DBMS basically supports both these type of query. A select query where the user requires certain data or information out of the database, or an action query where certain part of the database need to be modified. As we know, mostly these DBMS are supporting what is called as an online transaction processing or OLTP processing system that are designed to manage transaction data which are volatile. In a typical organization, you can expect there are thousands of transactions happening every day, and all the data related, all these transactions is being captured, and that kind of system is called as an online transaction processing system. Now this data is called as a volatile because it is continuously changing, and then this is being done using database management system. Language supported and widely used for querying a select query, action query and accessing the database is based on a standard called as an SQL. Now here you can see that there is a typical scenario of the data and the database. This shows some part of a database management system being used in a school or a college. You can see that there is a database which consists of all the data. Now the then there is another software which is an interface, and that interface software is called as the database management system or the DBMS. Now you can imagine that there are different users, like there can be a registrar of a college or an accountant of a college or gymkhana in charge of the college, and these users are using different application program. For example, there is a program related application program related to the class information, there is an application program related to the account information or account data, there can be some front end program, application program related to the sports, and all these application program which are being used by the user, they require the access to the database, and then this program they can access the database using a program or using a computer software called as the database management system. So you can see that there is only one set of database or one set of data which is being accessed by the different user and the different programs, and then managing all that is the function of the database management system. So as the title over here reads, database management system provide access to all data in a database for the different application programs. Now here you can pause the video and can answer the question, what are the functions, different functions of database management system? So what are the different functions that can be fulfilled or that can be supported by a typical database management system? You can take an example and then you can enlist all those functions those are supported by a typical database management system. Okay, I think that you have come up with an answer, what are the different functions supported by the database management system, and let us go ahead with this. Now what is the need of the database? Why we require the database and data management system, right? Now this database management determines the productivity of the managers and the employer, means the how efficiently these databases are being designed and how efficiently these databases are being managed, they decide the productivity of the managers and employees who are using these databases through database management system. Another goal is that the raw data need to be transferred into the information. In couple of lectures back, we have discussed about there is a data, there is a database, the data can be converted into information, information can be converted into knowledge, knowledge can be converted into wisdom. Then the databases and this database management system can extract certain information out of this data available. Another need of the database and the database management system is that while the managers, the lower managers or the higher managers, they have to come upon certain decision, they have to take certain decision, and for taking this decision they require certain data and information, and this data and information can be retrieved or can be churned out of the database using this DBMS. And lastly, the advantage of using database and database management system is that data errors and inconsistencies can be reduced. Now, what are the problems and challenges? Once we understand why we require an organized and systematic way of maintaining the data that we are calling as a database, and why we require a software called as the database management system, then we come to the understanding of what are the problems and challenges of data management. The first and the foremost problem or the challenge, I will not call it as a problem, but the challenge is that the volume of the data is increasing exponentially with time. Every day, the new data is getting added to the organizational database, internal and external data, and managing is a real challenge. The second challenge is that the data is coming through different sources. It is coming from internal source, it is coming from an external source. The data is scattered throughout the organization, and the data is either structured data or unstructured data. It has different format. Collecting all that data and integrating it together is also a challenge. For a particular application, an offline data is being used, the validity of that data is also questionable. Data redundancy means that the same data is available in a duplicate form, and maintaining that will require some more resources, and hence this data redundancy need to be which is a data which is redundant, which is duplicate or copy, has to be chopped off, has to be removed. Data inconsistency is the actual data values are not synchronized across the various copies. We have seen that we have something called as a replicated database. In case of replicated database, we are maintaining multiple copies of the same data, and then synchronizing them can also be a challenge. Data updation, some of the data may be stale, and then whenever the new transaction happens, the data need to be updated immediately. Isolating important data from less important data, not all the data is important or some part of that data is important. Identifying the data which is important for the organization and separating it is also a challenge. Security is again a big, we know that there can be a hacking problem, there can be malware problem. Protecting the data against this is also a big challenge. Preventing data in the error. If there is an error in the data, after processing also, those error can cause some problem. And then removing those error, preventing those error is also a challenge. And concurrency means that if two or one or more applications, they are accessing the data at the same time, and how to handle this kind of situation is called the data concurrency. So we have seen that although database management and databases are required, there are certain challenges in implementing them. So to deal with these difficulties, organization use the database management system. And as I say, it's a computer software program which take care of all these things. So this is how the database and database management system is working. The data is located in a database and the user want to access the data, and then the user can access the data using a software called as the database management system. So with that, we stop here. And these are the references which is being used for this part of the lecture, which include Information Technology for Management by Turban Volvino. The second book is Information System by Ralph Steer and George Renault. And I also used a book called as Information Technology for Management. It is by Turban and Woods. Thank you very much for joining the lecture, and see you in the next class. Thank you.